What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another episode of Muay Thai's Hidden Secrets by Thai Fight. I'm your host, Pontakorn Warapi Pathanapong, and today we continue with our journey in search of more knowledge on Thailand's national treasure and one of the world's most recognizable martial arts forms, Muay Thai. Last episode, we introduced to you the Y Crew, a pre-fight ritual that is performed by Muay Thai fighters. The Y Crew has also been a part of Muay Thai for many centuries. As we mentioned before, the Y Crew is performed for several reasons: to pay respect, to focus on the fight, to intimidate the opponent, and to warm up the body. Today, we get into more detail with regards to the Y Crew and its movements. First, we begin with the basics. By this, I mean the fundamental moves of Y Crew every traditional fighter has to perform, regardless of what camp or team they represent. Number one, the Te Pano. You kneel down with your back straight, then you put your hands together in the familiar Y pose, with your hands over the chest. Number two, Gom Krao. You bend your over and touch the ground with your palms and forehead three times. You lean forward with both arms fully stretched to the front until the tips of your fingers touch the ground. You retract the arms as if you were scooping the soil to your chest. Number three, Tawai Bang Kong. You fully stretch your arms forward, hands pressed together, and lift them up with your thumbs touching between your eyebrows. Now you must bend your elbows, look upwards, and lean your body slightly backwards as you do so. Lower your hands to your chest and repeat the step two more times. Number four, Prong. You place both clenched fists to your chest and look ahead. Lean forward, swing your fist three times, and sit back on your left heel. Stretch out your right leg with the tip of the right foot opened and swing your fist three times for three sets. Then number five, there are three standing Y Crew moves, which consists of the Tep Ni Mit, the Kung Sheng Crew, and the Yang San Kung. Here, we have what we would consider the advanced moves of the Y Crew, each move with their own purpose. While these moves are advanced, they're actually simply just methods of warming up and conditioning the body. The reason for their names is due to them being easy to memorize when they're being taught by masters to fighters. The Pratram Plank Song. Literally translated, the move describes Rama firing an arrow at his opponent. I guess you could say that when a fighter performs this move before a fight, he is saying to his opponent, "I'm coming for you." Now, with such a beautiful name, this Y Crew move is simply another effective yet aesthetic conditioning exercise for the body prior to a fight. Now, as it imitates the character Rama reaching for an arrow in his quiver to fit onto his bow to fire at his opponent, the Pratram Plank Song is actually a Y Crew move that helps with stretching both the arms and the back.
ไปให้ความสำคัญก็คือว่าบรรดาฮีโร่หน้าจอตอนนี้ครับอยากให้น้องๆเดินตามรอยที่เขาครับน้องๆสามารถที่จะรวยเพราะมวยได้ครับนะครับแต่ก่อนนี่ไม่ใช่ว่าโอ้โหแล้วไปใช้อาชีพจะกินนักมวยเนี่ยอาจจะไม่มีอะไรเหลือเก็บแต่ว่าไทยไฟทำให้เห็นว่าค่าตัว200,000-300,000กล้าจ่ายครับแล้วก็มีเงินรางวัล2 ล้านคุณสมจิตครับ2 ล้านหนึ่งเงินเดือน15,000กับพุทธปริญญาตรีนี่ทำกี่ปีครับถึงจะได
้โอ้โหครับหลายสิบปีครับ
ทั้งชีวิตทั้งชีวิต
ที่จริงแล้วฮะนอกจากจะทำเงินให้กับทีมชาติแล้วสุดที่ทำได้ก็คือหน้าที่การงานด้วย
แน่นอนครับ
อย่างผมนะถ้าไปมาชกมวยนี่ผมไม่ได้เป็นทหารผมไม่รับใช้ชาติตอนนี้ยศร้อยเอกแล้ว
ครับผม
เพราะฉะนั้นเริ่มจากมวยจริงๆแล้วอย่างน้องๆหนูเนี่ยมาหัดเล่นกีฬาดีกว่า
ใช่แล้วครับแล้วบ้านโคกรัดบ้าน
The Sot Soi Ma La. Having heard of this move, it is such a strong contrast to everything having to do with Muay Thai. This move describes the action of creating a flower garment. Just hearing the name itself takes you away from the chaos of a Muay Thai match. The Sot Soi Ma La is about respecting all things in nature. It's also the move that's supposed to represent the beautyof the Y Crew dance. Call it the ambassador of the Y Crew if you will. Nevertheless, it aids in warming up the body. In this case, performing the Sot Soi Ma La will stretch the muscles in your arms While there is brutality in the sport of Muay Thai, there is no question that it is balanced out by the beauty from its aesthetic pre-fight ritual, the Y Crew dance. The fighting that comes with Muay Thai and the beautiful dancing in the Y Crew pre-fight ceremony somehow go together like the yin and the yang. After all, opposites do attract. The Y Crew has always been an important component of Muay Thai and will always continue to be in many years to come. Anyways, that's it for today's episode of Muay Thai's Hidden Secrets by Thai Fight. I'm your host Pontagon Urapi Patanapong, and until then, have a wonderful day. If you liked this video, be sure to smash that like button down below for more videos like this. Subscribe to our channel, Thai Fight Official, and don't forget to click on the bell button so you know when we've uploaded a new video. You can also like our official Facebook page, Thai Fight King of Muay Thai, and also follow us on Instagram. Links will be provided in the description box down below.